In this video, we'll explore nucleotides, the essential building blocks of DNA. We'll delve into their structure, compare the two types of nucleic acids, DNA and RNA, and take a closer look at the structure of a single-stranded DNA molecule. Nucleic acids are linear macromolecules that are formed by the polymerization of building blocks that we call nucleotides. They're grouped into two types: deoxyribonucleic acids, known as DNA, and ribonucleic acids, known as RNA. DNA and RNA differ in the chemical structure of these nucleotide building blocks. Both deoxyribonucleotides in DNA and ribonucleotides in RNA are made up of three components. The first component is a pentameric monosaccharide. The second is a phosphate group, and the third component consists of nitrogenous bases, three of which are found in both DNA and RNA. However, there are two important differences in the chemical structure of DNA and RNA. The pentameric monosaccharide in DNA is deoxyribose, and the pentameric monosaccharide in RNA is ribose. In DNA and RNA, the fourth nitrogenous base is also different. DNA contains thymine, whereas RNA contains uracil. Let's focus on the pentoses found in DNA and RNA. The carbon 2 prime of deoxyribose contains hydrogen, which confers low chemical reactivity but very high stability. This is important since DNA carries genetic information that is transmitted across generations. On the carbon 2 prime of ribose, there is a hydroxyl group, usually notated as -OH, which is responsible for some of RNA's chemical activity. It also leads to the low stability and rapid degradation of messenger RNAs. Both ribose and deoxyribose have a hydroxyl group on their carbon 3 prime. This is critical for the polymerization of nucleotides into nucleic acid because they're part of the synthesis of the 3 prime to 5 prime phosphate ester linkage. The phosphate groups carried by the 5' carbon of ribose and deoxyribose are also critical for RNA and DNA polymerization. They form part of the 3' to 5' phosphodiester linkage between the building blocks of DNA and RNA. The four nitrogenous bases can be either pyrimidines or purines. Let's begin by looking at the pyrimidine bases, cytosine and thymine. Remember that in RNA, thymine is replaced by another pyrimidine base, uracil. Pyrimidines are heterocycles that contain 4 carbon and 2 nitrogen atoms. They're linked to the carbon 1 prime of deoxyribose or ribose. Purine bases include adenine and guanine. Purines are heterocycles that contain a pyrimidine ring fused to an imidazole ring. Purines are also linked to the carbon 1 prime of deoxyribose or ribose. A nucleoside is a nitrogenous base linked to its pentameric sugar, ribose or deoxyribose, whereas a nucleotide is a nucleoside with 1, 2, or 3 phosphate groups attached to the carbon 5 prime of deoxyribose or ribose. So, if we examine the primary structure of a DNA strand, we see that nucleotides in the polymer are connected between the 3' carbon of one deoxyribose and the 5' carbon of the next deoxyribose. This connection forms what is known as a 3' to 5' phosphodiester linkage. It is a linkage because it contains more than one covalent bond. They are between carbon 3' and oxygen, between oxygen and phosphate, between phosphate and oxygen, and finally one between oxygen and a 5' carbon. So how does this polymerization happen? On the left, you have a growing DNA strand. At the site of the growing end, you have the last nucleotide, the last deoxyribonucleotide with a free hydroxyl group attached to the 3' carbon. This free hydroxyl group will form a phosphodiester linkage with the phosphate carried by the 5' carbon of an incoming deoxyribonucleotide. This covalent linkage will lead to the incorporation of this incoming nucleotide. Therefore, the newly synthesized chain grows by one deoxyribonucleotide at a time. When a phosphodiester bond is formed, a pyrophosphate group is released and quickly degraded into two inorganic phosphates. This quick hydrolysis of pyrophosphate drives the equilibrium towards polymerization and away from depolymerization. So, in conclusion, DNA or RNA synthesis leads to a polynucleotide chain with a 3' to 5' polarity. A polynucleotide is characterized by both periodic and aperiodic elements. The periodic elements are the sugar-phosphate-sugar-phosphate linkages that alternate to form the sugar-phosphate backbone of the DNA strand. The aperiodic sequence is due to the diversity of the four nitrogenous bases that are attached to the phosphate backbone. The primary structure of a polynucleotide chain, whether it's DNA or RNA, is defined by the order of nucleotides in the linear polymer. The primary structure contains deoxyribonucleotides that are linked by phosphodiester linkages. The contents of this slide apply to both RNA and DNA. However, while both share the same basic polynucleotide structure, they exhibit key differences in function and complexity that are crucial to their respective roles in the cell. DNA molecules have a simple structure, while RNA molecules form complex tri-dimensional structures. DNA binds to proteins. These proteins are needed for the level of compaction and gene expression. RNA molecules associate with proteins to form a variety of functional ribonucleoprotein complexes, such as ribosomes. DNA molecules store hereditary information, while RNA molecules have both structural and catalytic functions. RNA genomes are also found in some viruses.